find out from that answer sheet, rather I would call it the score sheet, what are the elements of mastery. And in M, we will find two aspects. There will be two elements in the score sheet which are part of mastery. So anyone who could find out mastery from that score sheet, anything called mastery? Just have a look.
Environmental mastery,
I'll write it here. Environmental mastery leads to happiness. Environmental mastery typically means when I have resources to control my environment. I am a GM, so I have a car to take me to office. I have a few people who can help me out. I have a whole team which can take things to its conclusion. At the same time, the team is a very distorted, disengaged team, then you have it. That means the environmental mastery is going away from you, and are we not unhappy? सुबह मेड नहीं आई, या मेड आती है तो उत्पटांग काम करती है, या कभी बोलती है आएगी नहीं आती है, तो जो हाल होता है वही है एनवायरनमेंट मास्टर. इफ आई हैव द कंट्रोल कि मेड टाइम पे रेगुलरली आएगी एंड सब कुछ जैसे मैं चाहती हूँ वैसे या चाहता हूँ वैसे ही करेगी, सो वी आर हैप्पी. सो एनवायरनमेंटल मास्टरी इज माई एबिलिटी, माई कॉम्पिटेंस टू हैंडल माई एनवायरनमेंट. आई हैव अ पोजिशन, आई हैव पावर, आई हैव एनर्जी, आई हैव पीपल रिसोर्सेज, ऑल दोज थिंग्स हेल्प मी do something so that the environment becomes as I want it to be. Are we not be happy in those conditions? Ye ek happiness ka point hai. But the issue is always it is not under my control. So in each one of these elements, M, B and A, we have two aspects. One is known as the outer world aspect. So environmental mastery is outer world aspect where I need to be competent. मुझे management सीखना है, leadership सीखना है, कुछ technology सीखना है so that I can handle my laptop or my gadget. That's environmental mastery. I'm learning, putting in efforts to do some things. So environmental mastery is required. I need to enhance my competence, my ability to perform so that I can handle my environment. मुझे सीखना है, मुझे बात करना सीखना है, कम्युनिकेशन सीखना है. हाउ टू टाइटन द मेड इज अ कैलिबर. इफ आई नो दैट आई कैन बिकम बेटर एट दैट. हाउ टू टाइटन पीपल हु आर डिसएंगेज, नॉट वर्किंग, नॉट टेकिंग थिंग्स राइटली इन द राइट स्पिरिट. इफ आई नो दैट माई एनवायरमेंट मास्टर वुड हेल्प मी हाउ टू ऑर्गनाइज पीपल अराउंड, हाउ टू ऑर्गनाइज थिंग्स. सो दैट्स एन आउटर वर्ल्ड फिनोमेना. इन ईच ऑफ दिस थिंग्स we'll also talk about something called the inner world phenomena. The outer world phenomena, we need to put in a lot of efforts to gather some competence. In the inner world phenomena, it may not be the same rule that applies. For example, sleeping is an inner world phenomena. Sleeping ek inner world hai, and bed and going to bed, timely going to bed is outer world. It's something outside. Now, are they same or different? I go to bed at 10:30, रात के डेढ़ बजे तक मुझे नींद नहीं आ रहा है. कोशिश ज़्यादा लगाता हूँ, बहुत ज़्यादा करता हूँ और नींद उतने ही भागता जाता है. Does it happen with us?
Yes.
More we chase sleeping, sleeping recedes farther. This is the rule of the inner world. The outer world needs efforts to acquire things, competence. The inner world doesn't work that way. You need to drop something in order to acquire competence there. So, can you find out something in your questionnaire regarding the mastery? Any other elements? Mastery ke related aapko kuch dikh raha hai usme?
Autonomy?
Not exactly. Close? Not exactly. Aur koi aisa hai jo ki mastery ko depict karta hai lekin andar said it, sir. It is about personal growth. When we are referring to this term called growth, we are talking about my ability to control myself, my ability to sleep. my ability to think what I want to think, not about the red monkey. So my ability to make my internal things in order in the mental space is what is known as personal growth. So in the end, it's the personal growth. So M has got two elements, the environment mastery and the personal growth. We will have lot of discussion on all these aspects, how to energize, how to vitalize these aspects. In cheezon ko kaise badhana hai, how to improve this. We'll more talk about the inner world phenomena. Outer world, you are fabulous. You are all engineers, MBAs, CEOs, GMs, and you have those caliber for which you have been successful in life so far. But successful within, in the inner world, want something very, very different, because the laws are different. And we'll try to appreciate, understand those laws of inner world and then move forward. So the aspect of personal growth we'll discuss more compared to the environment mastery, where inner world is jo Jitendra bata rahe the ki eudaimonic aspects. Andar kya ho raha hai usko agar hum theek kar paye to long term happiness aayega. So we'll talk about that as we move on. So personal growth is the inner world aspect of M. Now the second thing is, so ye ho gaya mastery. Second one is called B for belongingness. Simple form mein relationship. Simple form mein belongingness is how I relate to others. How I am related to the nature, how I am related to my family, my society, my organization, things around. Anything you're finding there?
Positive relationships.
Positive relationships. So we are writing positive. The positive relationship. सुबह हम लोग कुछ देर के लिए एक एक्टिविटी कराए थे. द पर्पस वाज हाउ वी फील व्हेन वी कनेक्ट विद समबडी विद पॉजिटिविटी. कैसा लगा था आपको? मैं से बहुत लोग बोले थे बहुत अच्छा लगा. द मोमेंट वी कनेक्ट विद एनी इंडिविजुअल, एनी ह्यूमन बीइंग विद अ सेंस ऑफ पॉजिटिविटी, वी आर फाइंडिंग समथिंग न्यू, वी आर फाइंडिंग समथिंग इंटरेस्टिंग इन हिम और हर, विद अ लॉट ऑफ पॉजिटिव एस्पेक्ट्स विद हिम, द हैप्पीनेस नेचुरली सिप्स इन. इट्स something by nature. The moment we are relating to somebody, just hug somebody, you will find so happy. Even a pet, even the trees, the nature. So anything outside, when we are connecting with that, with a lot of positivity, we call it a positive relationship, and positive relationship zooms happiness. More and more positive relationship we create, it just makes us happy. That's a natural phenomenon. So simple. Dr. Chetri would take us through something called how to enrich that positive relationship through some practices. So positive relationship is profound. It can make us happy just sheer thinking and practicing those small things. So positive relationship, although is very powerful, again it's about something outside. My son, my mother, my friends, my boss, my subordinates. मेरे बॉस के साथ बहुत बढ़िया रिलेशनशिप है तो बहुत अच्छा है, अगर नहीं है तो we know what happens. So positive relationship, the counterpart is equally destructive also. It destroys happiness to a large extent. So relationship does matter. Anything you find out about the inner world of relationship. You see anything in any questionnaire mein dekh lijiye, anything which is related to the inner aspect of relationship. There are 6 factors. We'll put them into these 3 boxes of MBA.
Purpose in life.
Purpose in life, close, not purpose. Self acceptance. Yeah, said it again. Self acceptance is about how I accept myself, how I am connected to myself, how deeply I understand myself and accept myself. we all feel that we will be the super human beings. I should do everything right, I should be the biggest person once. But what I am I accepting it? Am I connected to myself? Am I with me? The very presence with myself. Do I have an appointment with me sometime in a day? Do I see myself? Do I introspect? Do I understand myself and love myself? Many of us, we don't love ourselves. And just by sheer loving our self, we do not know what that self exactly depicts, what does it mean. But definitely we'll try to explore through this aspect, through this abstract phenomena called self. What is the self and do I love myself? That's also would be one thing. Dr. Chetri would be there, of course, will guide us through some processes. But that's profound. When I accept myself, many things are not required. They just happen. Happiness just ensues. You don't need to pursue it. It just happens. So, self-acceptance. Not many left now. Now we come to A. A stands for autonomy or freedom. There is one thing very straightforward. Autonomy is there. And the other one is also there. So freedom or autonomy. Do you think this is required for happiness?
Yes.
If I'm free, abhi hum log bahut zyada free hain. Koi chakkar nahi hai. Khana aa jata hai ya sona bahut sara hai tak free. Koi bolne wala nahi hai. No time ka aisa bhi nahi hai ki koi piche se dhakka de raha hai. Or there is absolutely nothing. Agar nahi hota hai to koi aisa nahi hai ki koi punish kar dega. So we are very free. So freedom is one of the fundamental elements of happiness of the human beings. All these elements will try to decipher through what is known as cognitive neuroscience. It's a fascinating arena for me. I have been doing a lot of study on cognitive neuroscience, which suggests what happens in our brain, which leads to our behavior, our expression, our presence, what we are. And is that the brain is the final thing or something beyond the brain which is there, which can do all these things or which is leading to do all these things? We'll try to find out both these facets. The brain, how powerful is it? What is it doing for us? What part of the brain is engaged when I'm speaking, you're listening? What part of the brain is engaged when I'm hugging somebody? What is happening when I'm in good relation or in a bad relation with somebody? What happens when I dislike, say, a particular insect? Or what happens when there is the boss is howling at me or the wife is angry? So all these things we'll try to figure out. What is there, what happens in the brain, and if it is so, is it natural or we have not learned how to handle it better? So we'll try to look and try to unearth those secrets. I would not say secret, a lot of fascinating things happening in this arena. A lot of things happening on the brain research, and you would all be amazed to know now everything is pointing finger towards what the Indian philosophy has been saying for ages. The Upanishads, the Vedas, the Bhagavad Gita, the essential aspect, the Buddhist philosophy, the essential aspect of human being. Now they're finding, wow, how this could come to the brain of people who lived 3,000 years before. How could somebody perceive this unthinkable things? There must be something, some extraterrestrial interference over there. So this is fascinating journey which has been happening, started very recently. As one of the scientists there, he said, we have seen a lot of revolution, the industrial revolution, the digital revolution is happening. Probably we can attribute this coming century as the consciousness revolution, and the essential fundamental aspect of consciousness revolution starts from here, from this land, from this very place. So we should feel proud, but at the same time, most of us, we have forgotten the essential aspect of this. Now the Westerners are, as yesterday I was chatting with Dr. Chetri, the Westerners have started saying what mindfulness is all about. Recently I had been to Delhi, had an interaction with a very profound guy called Rasmus Hugard. He has a company over 200 odd countries, known as the Mindful Leadership, that company's name. So he started the session saying that, first, forgive me, and I'm feeling so embarrassed. I have come to the country to teach mindfulness where it all started. So that's the profound statement he made before commencing the whole journey of that course of half a day. So A is about autonomy. A is about purpose of life, in which the autonomy, my freedom outside. Do I do something because my boss is saying, or it is I am doing that way? Do I do something because I'm compelled to do it, or I, from my wholehearted intentions, I'm doing those? So autonomy comes here, but autonomy again comes from something outside. Freedom depends on the environment. Morning 6 baje to uthna padega, bus aayegi school mein, bacche jayenge bus mein, bacche jayenge school. So again, autonomy is something which not necessarily all the time with us. We have to sometimes maybe sacrifice our freedom. But autonomy outside, mere paas 4 gaadiyan hain, 2 gaadi idhar, 2 gaadi udhar, jaake main office pe jaunga, bachcho ko bhi chhodenge. So autonomy sometimes comes from our resources again, my power, my money, my all those things. But again, this has suggest not happiness. For happiness, some people are autonomous by internal mechanism. Let's take an example, simple example of Nelson Mandela. Most of his life he was in the prison, and the prison size was less than 10 by 10 square feet. He was there, including the toilet in that 10 by small place for there. Was he free or was he not? Physically he was captivated. Physically he was confined. No movement, cannot just move out as per his choices, whims and fancies. But was he free? The purpose in his life of getting rid of appetite was making him free for all the time during his lifetime. Do you all agree?
Yes.
One purpose made him free, and that's what we call the inner world of freedom. So it is purpose in life. I cannot, actually we cannot guarantee you about the right side of things. I don't know what is the resource that you have. I don't know what is the competence that you have handling things, the complexities that you are in. We don't know what kind of relationships are there. The bosses are with many people, are friends. And we also don't know what kind of autonomy, what kind of power that you enjoy to control the outside world for your freedom. But certainly, we can assure you, with certain practices, the inner world, all of us, we have been given with exceptional capability of becoming wonderful human beings. We can be happy all the time. We can be in a state of ananda at my choice. That's what we are here for. Ananda, can it come as per my choice, not by somebody else's choice? The outer world would be somebody else's choice, the environment's choice. So our whole endeavor for these 2 days would be to find out, can this be my choice? And we hope collectively, again, I don't know, collectively we learn from each other. We bring in some concepts differently, but concepts are concepts. We only can make those happen to us when we practice them. So that practice is what we are going to talk about. In Bhagavad Gita, Sri Krishna started saying something on the battlefield. Aisa karna chahiye, waisa karna chahiye, wo karna chahiye. And you should control your mind. And Arjuna bola, ye to bada mushkil baat kar raha hai. Sab kuch jo bata rahe ho aap, these are all very, very difficult things. How can one do that? So Sri Krishna, although Arjuna asked it very politely, Sri Krishna said something very profound at that point in time. He said, I know these are very, very difficult. Asansayam mahabahe mano durnigraham chalam. It's absolutely difficult to control your mind. That's why it's so difficult. It's very, very fickle. But there is a way. There is a way through which we can actually improve. We cannot be absolutely master of that. but we can definitely improve. Asansayam mahabahi mano durnigram chalam avhyasena tu kaunteya vairagyena cha gruhyate. He says we can achieve this with two very simple things, but simple things are not easy. Simple things are simple, they are not easy. Simple things means subah utke morning walk jaane se fit rehna is a very simple thing. We know fit rehne ke liye khana badhiya chahiye, fitness ke liye exercise chahiye, sona thoda chahiye. So these are the few simple things, simple steps for happiness or for fitness. But easy? Subah utke chalne jana, that itself is so difficult. So Asan saying mahavaya mano durnigram chal, the mind is so frequent, so difficult to control. But there are two simple steps, not easy steps. Vairagya, abhyasena tu kaunteya, so you have to practice it. So our journey is how we practice these things so that we actually enhance these, the inner world aspects. The exceeding, hand over to Dr. Chatri. Very recent research suggests the human evolution is not complete. This has been said by many of the seers and philosophers. Recent research by one Dr. Richard Davidson, who has a center called, is a huge center for mindfulness and understanding human brain on contemplative neuroscience. When people practice meditative practices, go through meditative practices, what happens? Now he says, the human evolution is still in a work in progress. And people who have been going towards this would find a different species altogether. It is a different species, not at the physical level, maybe at some other space. So with this, we all let's strive towards moving this journey, moving this end rather, purpose, of how we can make ourselves happy, we can take responsibility of our happiness, our ananda. So with this, I think, thank you very much.
What about this course? Where do we stand?
Yes, of course, I'll let you know a little later, or should I do it right now? I thought discourse are very personal, so I would, it's your choice to share or not to share. If in any of this course you are 5+, that means in that category you are in a happy zone. It's very good. So 5+ is very good. 5.5+ is excellent. 4.5.
Close to that.
4 to 5. It's good. Good. 3 to 4, you need to... that means there is something which is bugging you, bothering you, where we need to work on. So 3 to 4 is... we need to work on. If it is below 3, it's definitely a matter of concern. Something is definitely disturbing you, creating disturbance. So I would say that is a low score. 3 to 4 is fair. 4 to 5 is good. 5 and above is very good. It is close to 6 or 6, it's an exception. But with a little caution, every questionnaire has its own problems as well. Sometimes, hum logo question ko sahi tarike se samajh nahi paate hain. Wo jo batana chahta hai, jo janna chahta hai. Plus, this is an, of course, Western questionnaire. So, hamara jo psyche hai, kahin na kahin thoda disconnect ho sakta. That may be the reason. But इसका हर एक क्वेश्चन है को आप वर्बटिव मत लीजिए. आप उसको देख के एक बार सोचिए कि सही में ये काम है क्या मेरा, एनवायरमेंट मास्टर मेरा सही में काम है क्या. कई जगह जैसे मेनी ऑफ द पीपल हु आर वर्किंग इन इन गवर्नमेंट सेक्टर, पब्लिक सेक्टर, वुड फाइंड हियर देयर इज अ रियल चैलेंज. सो दिस मे बी लो. सो यू कैन रिफ्लेक्ट ऑन ईच वन ऑफ दिस. एनी वेयर यू आर बिलो 3, डेफिनेटली डेफिनेटली इट्स अ प्लेस वेयर वी शुड वर्क ऑन टू इम्प्रूव आवर हैप्पीनेस. And we, that is the cause of unhappiness that you can find out. If I'm not feeling happy, is it because of something in the mastery zone? I'm unable to handle it. Is there some problem with the relationship zone? Or is there something to do with my autonomy? Somebody else is dictating terms. Whether husband is dictating terms, or the wife is dictating terms, or the boss is dictating terms. But that dictating terms can be unhappiness for somebody. We'll get into some more domains of understanding mindset as you come back after the lunch. We'll have some funny activities also, but now I would request Swami Chetri to take it forward. The mind aspect, of course, being a master of this arena, I request you, sir, to please take it forward.
Thank you.